If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold. And when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you.
And peace be unto you. Please stand for reception of the body of Jamal, Jamar, Derek, Octave, Pearce. And he said, my presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest. Let me die the death of the righteous, and let my last end be like his. The eternal God is their refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. The Lord gave, and the Lord have taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Though he slay me, yet will I trust in him. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in our time of trouble. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and is safe. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him will I trust. Behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and not be afraid, for the Lord Jehovah is my strength and my song. He also has become my salvation. Thou wilt keep in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee, because he trusteth in thee. Trust in the Lord forever, for the Lord Jehovah is everlasting strength. Fear thou not, for I'm with thee. Be not dismayed from thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will hold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Before I invite the Reverend Marina Taylor to do the opening prayer, just want to, on behalf of the church family here at the Bible Church of the Nazarene, as well as the executive board, we want to convey our heartfelt condolences to the family and friends of a deceased one. And our prayer for you today is that God's divine strength would undergird you as you go through this time of phenomenal loss. Let's pause for opening prayer. I want to invite the Reverend Marina Taylor to come at this time and to pray for us.
Shall we pray? Our Heavenly Father, we bow in your presence even now. Lord, we can sense the heaviness in the service this morning because of the pain and the grief that envelops so many of these young people who are here today. But God, we are glad that we are serving a God who is acquainted with our pain, who is acquainted with sorrow, who is acquainted with grief. And therefore, Lord, we entrust every one of them in your hands today. We thank you for your loving kindness and your tender mercies, God. You have promised never to leave us, never to forsake us. You have promised to be our refuge, a place that we can run and hide. Our strength, oh God, when our physical strength sometimes seemingly is gone, Lord, as we draw our strength from you this morning, we pray, Father, that you will hear and answer our cry today. I pray, Holy Spirit of God, that you would move upon this auditorium today. Minister to every heart and every life that is here today, Lord. And I pray, God, that the God of all comfort would, oh Father, become real in the lives of men and women, boys and girls, God. Oh Father, today, let them have an encounter with you, mighty God, knowing that you love and you care for us, even in our deepest moments, when we are down in the valley. Oh God, we thank you this morning, and we pray, God, that while we share in this Thanksgiving service, that God, you will reveal some things to us and help each one of us to know that we truly need you. And if ever there's a time we need you, it is now, Lord. And I pray that you will have your way. In Jesus' name I ask with thanksgiving. Amen, amen and amen.
Praise the Lord. Good morning to everyone. My sincere condolences to the family and friends of Jamal. At this time, we're going to sing that hymn, Amazing Grace, How Sweet the Sound That Saved a Wretch Like Me. We give God thanks this morning for his amazing grace. Praise the Lord.
Through many dangers, tall.
God's praise than when we first begun. Thank God for amazing grace. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for your amazing grace. At this time, we're going to be blessed with a tribute and song from the St. Leonard's Boys Choir. You may be seated.
Y'all want to use this as well? Y'all can have this as well. Y'all want it?
No, not really.
Okay.
Yeah, I got time for you.
Thank you.
Good morning to all. I just want to say a big thank you to Jamal's family for lending him to us for many years. And we would have traveled, we would have had some great times in the choir, and we are truly grateful for his life and his service to our in the choir, and certainly at St. Leonard's Boys School. Thank you so much. Eh?
Grand miss you very much, especially when I'm in the kitchen going to fry chicken or fish. I miss you around me and hearing your voice. Grand miss all the video calls we just call on a day, especially when you going to work and I see the blue sky over your head and I will say, "Hi, Mali, look the sky," and you will be there pulling your beard and making funny little motions to Granny. Grand miss you very much. Anyhow, my love, rest in peace till Granny join you. Love you always.
If I wouldn't know that you wouldn't be here anymore, I wouldn't make the moments last a little longer. 'Cause now I'm alone, and you're just a memory in my mind. Oh, how I'd give anything to say goodbye. If I would've known. If I would've known, oh, 'cause now I'm alone, if I would've known, oh, Jamali, Tia Rosa loves you, you're an angel. I can't forget every evening I go by Mama and I would ask Jamal here and Mama would say, look at the door and see if you see his slippers. And I would go to your bedroom door if I see them and knock. And you would just come to the door smiling. And if it were Monday, the days that you're off, and I say, "Jamal, you don't go to work," you would be like, "Auntie, you mean every Monday you going to ask me so?" And I can never forget that last meal you made for me. Those delicious wings. That night before you passed away. And you called me and said, "Auntie, you want sauce panda? Come, I got sweet and chili. Come. Sweetheart, I love you. You would always be in my heart. Rest in peace, Jamali. Rest in peace."
On this sad day, we say farewell to Jamal. He was a blessed child. He was loved from the day he was born to the day he left us. He was loved. He was a blessing. He was a loving child. He was a good friend to all who knew him. He loved children. The most I remember is when the first day I had to explain to my son, when I had to be mommy and daddy. When his first, I would say, the first time he was in love to have a girlfriend and got his heart broken. Jamal cried. When I came home, Jamal was wailing. And I guess the Lord gave me the right words to tell him and to reassure him that life just throws some hard curveballs, but it's how you dust yourself off and just, you know, move on. But everyone who knew Jamal, who got to know him, knew he was a fun child. He loved music, he loved dancing, he loved children. He and his cousin Michaela, he was so close to Michaela from the time she came home. Jamal was by her side. He never left her side up to now. Up to now, he had to go to a better place, as I put it. So let's think of him as how he was. He would always be in my heart. I loved him. Each and every one of us who knew him loved him. So Jamal, where I know you're up there, you're singing and you're dancing and you're looking down on us. You will look out for us. I want to read a little something from your uncle. He can't be here to say goodbye to you, but he sent you a note. Gone too soon, like a beautiful full moon, full with memories which bring laughter and tears when we decide to share how much we care.
We are shoot the star, see, we're amazing, see, we're homie. I'm alive, feel like diamonds in the sky. On you, it rain like gum right away. Hey, right away. I saw the light shine bright tonight. You went long, like beautiful, like diamonds in the sky. Shine bright like a diamond, shine bright like a diamond, shine bright like a diamond. Rest in peace, Jamal, I love you.
Testing. What a beautiful tribute. Rest in peace, Jamal, indeed. At this time, we're going to have the eulogy, and it will be read by Andrew Octave.
Good morning.
Good morning. We have one more tribute, which will be given verbally. Then I'll read a short eulogy.
Sorry for hijacking the eulogy. My name is Krista. I'm Jamal's sister. This is my Mali. Farewell. You were the brother I wished for on a January birthday, turn 9. You came in the year of my 10th. I had hoped we would have years together, but now it feels like only months. As siblings, we had differences that made a wedge, but when either of our safety was threatened, we showed up, for that was our pinky finger pledge. I will remember you, my Mali, as the cutest baby. I will remember you, my Mali, as the brother I played Tetris with for hours in mama bedroom, hours. I remember you, my Mali, as a child I had to chase around to take a shower. Jeremy, remember? Boy ran outside in the green underwear in one bed. I remember your smile, my brother, for it made you forget what we were punishing you for. Because that same smile made it easy for me to take you anywhere you went. I remember that Friday you and Mario left school with wanting to spend a weekend by me. But Eric disapproved, so your master plan failed tragically. I remember how you felt in all your stages of growth, from hair to your neck, to none because of a ringworm, and then some. I remember every cut, every cry, every dream, every success, and every sorrow. Even though I stay silent as you walk your path as an adult, I checked every post, every stat, silently patting you on your back. I'll forever miss you, forever think of you, forever lift you up. Because we did not get any last farewell, no moment to hear your final goodbye. You were gone before we knew it, and only you and God know why. A million times we will miss you, a million times we will cry. Because if love alone could have saved you, I have no doubt you have never died. In life, I loved you dearly. In death, I love you still. And in our hearts, you hold a place that no one else or any physical thing can fill. It broke my heart to see you lying still, signaling the loss of you to a greater will. But you have not gone alone, for pieces of all of us have met with you. I thank that morning God took you home, and I hope someday I meet you again. Because we will have to ride our bicycles in the sun straight to Miami Beach. I thank God he made you my brother, and I would have had no other. While you were on earth, I lift you up. Goodbye, Mabby.
Good morning, everyone. The eulogy is a compilation of everyone who put together their emotions and their feelings for him, and this is what it says. First of all, we would like to say a special thanks to everyone who has paid their respects to us and graced us with their presence here today to celebrate the life of our beloved Jamal, or Mali as affectionately known to most. It shows us how much he was loved, and that makes our hearts so happy that he touched so many lives in the short 27 years he had on this earth. Jamal, who was born June the 5th, 1995, to Deborah Octave and Eric Pearce, was a little troublesome brother to his sister, Crystal. But he was a shy boy who never talked much and would always have a smile on his face. He loved singing and dancing, and some of you might be surprised to know that he was a member of the boys, St. Leonard's Boys 100 Strong Choir. And even though he worked in an establishment that played karaoke, he wouldn't sing a note for anybody. We would beg and beg, but he just wouldn't budge. Just smiled as usual, you know, the pulling of the little beard. I was content to stay in the background, enjoying the music and the dancing. He even used to take his phone and speak it into the bathroom with him, music blasting, and he would be singing. As his friend Stefan said, the guys always wanted to know how he could learn a song so quickly from just hearing it once, and he had it down pat. As most of you know, Jamal would always have his phone in his hand, either playing a game, taking snaps, or listening to music, and that was his signature piece. He had a close relationship with his cousins, Michaela, Jamaria, Jermaine, Shani, who all grew up together. He and Michaela were inseparable from babies until the day he passed. The two of them would take care of their younger cousin, Kiara, and Jaden, with whom he developed an even close relationship by working together. His dad, with his quiet demeanor, who is devastated and grieving silently and sometimes openly for his only child, fondly remembers as a little boy, Jamal was fascinated with horses and buses, and he would always have to take him by the garrison to watch the horses run. But as he grew up, his interest turned, as most young boys would, to technology, games, cell phone, and such like. Mama, his grandmother with whom he lived, a woman of few words, is presently grieving silently. And she would always tell him when he was younger, "Boy, I never see anybody bathe so long and waste paper so." Oh, what she would give to hear him and to tell him these words now, the same words that she was complaining about. She also fondly recalls when he was small, "I did not want to eat his food." She would say, You ain't moving from here until all that food gone. And he would sit at the table for hours with the food in his jaw. His Auntie Sherry remembers his infectious smile, which will be etched in her memory forever. No matter what you said to him, it would end up with that smile and again the pulling of the beard. Every message he sent always started with, "Hi, Auntie." He was always respectful. I would always tell people how much and how proud I was that he grew up to be a fine young man and never got into any trouble. She told him he took away her chef of the coleslaw king after developing his culinary skills. First working with his aunt Jenny at the yard bar, and more recently with his last place of employment, J Escape Bar, alongside his cousin Jaden. His auntie Jenny said, and I quote, "I remember you coming into my kitchen a morning and saying, 'Auntie, I come to work for you because I want money.' And skinning the teeth. You could even peel a potato back then when you first started, but you ended up being an awesome cook. I will always miss those texts in the morning. I would give anything now to hear you say, 'Auntie, you got money? I want sign to eat.' I will love you forever." He would spend quiet time with his grandmother, Margarita. Every day, whether it be on video calls or the occasional visit to her home. And especially while he was eating food, he would always text her or video call her to show her, "Aunt, grand, look what you're eating." And while he was on his way to work, as she said, he would always be calling her, showing her the sky, you know, and again, pulling the beard. Deborah, his mom, is devastated with this unexpected turn of events, as she has lost her only son. Auntie Rosie, the rock of the family, who is dear for everyone, has now crumbled from this loss, but still she's the one pressing forward in the forefront, doing what she does naturally. She's the one the kids played pranks on, especially Jamal, and he would just camp away, laughing at her reaction. We always told her she spoiled him rotten, as she usually did, along with his grantee over there. But that dreadful phone call on March 19th, 2023 changed the lives of our families and friends in the blink of an eye. And what hurt the most is that we didn't get a chance to say a proper goodbye. Our consolation is his best friend, Stefan, with whom he had been friends with from school. He was there with him, and we are grateful for the brave measures he took in trying to save his life. We understandably now question why him? And maybe later down when our tears have flowed a little less and our pain has eased a bit, we might be able to accept that God wanted him for a special reason. Both families are in a state of turmoil, and most can't express their feelings at this stage. But hopefully, as time goes on, we will be able to speak his name with laughter and look at his photos a little easier. And we will remember the life he touched each and every single one of us, and the impact he has on us. As we gather here, each of us has a bit of memory that we will always cherish. So Jamal, Mali, Master Yota, we love you. We miss your smiling face. You will be forever in our hearts, never to be forgotten. Sleep peacefully until we meet again. Thank you.
Okay, could we stand, please, as we read the first scripture, which will be taken from Psalms 23, and Andrew is going to read it.
Good morning, it's me again. scripture reading is taken from Psalms 23, and it begins, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Here ends the scripture reading.
Okay, just before we have the offertory and the hymn, we're going to ask Michaela Pearce to come and give us a tribute. You may be seated again as Michaela comes. Okay.
Good morning. Jamal and I are cousins, but we were more like sister and brother. The bond between us were unbreakable, but sadly, on March 19th, it was broken. We always looked out for each other. Jamal always had my back, no matter what. Up to the day he died, I remember as a child, we couldn't go outside to play till he finished eat. And I would always sneak and eat some. And then Jamal would stuffle the rest in his jaw and sometimes throw it over the paling, and it would stick onto the paling. And then we would run, showing Mama the plate, saying, "Look, we finished eat." We run outside laughing. Man, Jamal was so sweet. He would always involve me in anything he had planned. It was always Michaela for him. As most of you know, he was never a person to talk much, but he would always talk to me about anything. There are so much many more memories and so many more moments we shared. Rest peacefully, Jamal. I will never forget about you, and I would always love you.
Thank you, Michaela. At this time, we will receive an offering towards the church's building fund, and we'll sing that song, "Precious Lord, Take My Hand, Lead Me On."
Precious Lord.
Scripture reading. Not yet? Okay. All right. Okay. Well, let's just bow our heads as we bless the offering. Father, we thank you, O God, for you are the giver of life, dear Father. We thank you for giving to us that we can give back to your storehouse. I pray that you will bless it in Jesus' name and continue to strengthen the family of Jamal at this time. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. At this time, we'll have our second scripture reading, which will be taken from John chapter 14, verses 1 to 6 and verse 7. And this will be read by Sister Sonia Octave. Sonia? Let us stand.
Yeah. Good morning. Sorry. Today's scripture lesson is taken from 1 John 14, 1 to 6. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I'm going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you are going. So how can we know the way? Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Verse 27. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled and do not be afraid. Here ends the scripture verse.
Amen. At this time, we're going to have a solo that's going to be done by Joshua Osborne, Gone Too Soon. You may be seated. And after the solo, we'll welcome our pastor, Reverend Kelman, who is going to give us the address. Reverend Anderson Kelman.
Thank you. like a comet blazing across the evening sky. Gone too soon. Like a rainbow fading in the twinkling of an eye. Gone too soon. Shiny and sparkly and splendidly bright. Here one day, gone one night. Like a lost of sunlight on a cloudy afternoon. Gone too soon. Like a castle built upon a sandy beach. Gone too soon. Like a perfect flower that is just beyond your reach. Gone too soon. Born to amuse, to inspire, to delight. Here one day, gone one night. Like a sunset dying with the rising of the moon. Gone too soon. Gone too soon.
Rest in peace, Jamal. We will remember you always. Thank you.
I think we all know it. I want to say thanks to you for that beautiful song that reminds us that life can be so very fleeting. And I pray that each one of us would acknowledge the truthfulness of that song. May the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, be accepted, I say, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. We read from the Gospel of St. John, and it talks about Christ's last days. And as we would recall, I think we will recall, that Christ was about to make his exit. And he had told the disciples he was going away. And of course, they were all grief-stricken. And I'm sure today that as you have sat here in this sanctuary of sorrow, most of you, if not all of us, are struck with grief. For death is always difficult. And when that death occurs with someone so young and bright, someone who was making such a valiant contribution to others and to this society, it makes it even more challenging and difficult. And so Christ, recognizing the challenge that was up ahead and knowing how difficult it would be for his disciples, he sought to bring them a measure of comfort. And so today I want to also, in like fashion, attempt to bring each of you a measure of comfort as well. And though they were all caught in the grip of grief, Christ asked them to consider a few things. Even while you feel so forsaken, disciples, I want you to just consider a number of things. And I also want to say to the family as well, that as you go through this time of loss and questioning, because that's normal. It's normal to ask questions. Why Jamal? Why now? I want you to miss that reality to consider a few things as well. And the first thing Christ said to them in chapter 14 is that in my Father's house, there are many mansions, or some versions render it, there are many rooms. I'm going to prepare a place for you. And I believe that he was helping them to understand that death is not the end. And I want to say to you relatives as well, as you mourn, that this is not the end. For God in Christ is preparing a place for us. You see, God knew how difficult death would be. And therefore, he seeks to cause us to look beyond the casket, to look beyond the grave, to understand that this is just merely a point of transition, or a period of transition, but this is not the end. St. John the Divine talks about that new city, Revelations 21 and 22. He talks about a city that's beautifully adorned for as a bride for her husband. That was the metaphor he used. It's a beautiful city that he talks about in chapter 22 of the streams that will be flowing through that city. A kind of, in a sense, it was Eden being remade or being refashioned. What John was saying is that there's a place beyond this life that God is preparing for all of us. And so death is not the end. I heard the one who gave the tribute ask the question or made the comment that I hope to see Jamal again. I want to say to you that is very possible. For in Christ, the word tells us that we shall again be reassembled in that new Jerusalem. So he's going to prepare a place for us, and death is not the end. The word also tells us in that 14th chapter that Christ has also given to us our personal pass, our ticket into that new place, that new Jerusalem. He says to us that I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. Thomas asked the question, you know, Master, you've said to us that death is not the end, and that there's a new place you're preparing for us, but how do we get there? And Christ said, I'm giving to you a personal pass to that new Jerusalem. Don't have to buy it from ticket center or from any place in Bridgetown or wherever. Online, that pass comes to us compliments of the blood of Jesus Christ. He says, I am the way. I am the pathway to that new place. If you are willing to accept me as your Lord and Savior, then your destination is already booked to Jerusalem, New Jerusalem. He says, I am the truth. If you live in me, then you will live a life of truth. Your life will be a life of wholesomeness and joy and peace. And yes, there will be difficult times, but in your heart, I would impute that sense of peace. If you live in me, then you will live a life of wholeness. I am the way, I am the truth. He says, I am the life. And that word life there talks about the life in John 10, the abundant life. It talks about that quality of life that we can live when Jesus Christ is with us and when His Holy Spirit is in our lives, we can live that abundant life, that life of peace, that life of joy. He's given to us a special place. He's praying for us. And He's given to us our path to get there. But between this life and the next, the 27th verse also says He's given to us of His peace, my peace. He says, I leave with you my peace, not as the world giveth, give I thee. As I began to think about the contrast between the world's peace and the peace of Christ, I thought about the fact that the world's peace is short-lived. You know, we heard some time ago about a new truce having been created between the different gangs that in Barbados, and what that means is that they are planning not to have any kind of strife, as was evident over the last few months and years, but every now and again we still hear something happening, you know, and so the peace of the world is very temporary. It's not permanent. The peace of the world is very fickle. You know, you watch the world governments, you know, at the sight of a one event occurring, a missile being fired somewhere, and the entire world is in chaos. And I'm sure you look at the whole Ukraine and Russia fiasco and ask yourself, what's the sense? That the peace of the world is very fickle. But Christ says, I will leave my peace with you. And I want to say to those of you who are grieving today that you can receive the peace of Almighty God. I want to say to you today that though this is a very difficult situation and journey, the loss of a loved one is challenging in every way. But even in the midst of that difficulty, you can experience the peace of God. And the Word of God gives us some characteristics of this peace. It says it's a peace that surpasseth all understanding. Philippians chapter 4 and verse 7. A peace that defies human logic or wisdom. It's a peace that comes from the very hand of God. It's a peace which would have kept Daniel in the lion's den or Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the fiery furnace. It's a peace that does not conform to human logic. It's a peace that is given by Almighty God. It's that shalom peace that even in the fires of life, we can know that the God that we serve is still in control, even when in our minds we can't understand it, we can't fathom it. There's a quietness that knows that our God is still on the throne. It's a peace that surpasseth all understanding. It's a peace that stabilizes us in the midst of the storms of life. If there's ever a time we need stability, it is now. With all that's happening around us, There's ever a time that with disabilities is now with the loss of someone that we love so dear. A peace that stabilizes us. And even though our boats may rock, speaking figuratively of our humanity may rock and seem to toss and want to turn over, we can trust God to stabilize us in the midst of the storm, because we understand that the peace of God is able to help us to be strong even in the face of adversity. Hear Jesus Christ as he hung from the cross. Father, forgive them, for they do not what they do. Even though in excruciating pain with nails in his hands and feet, he was still able to exude that sense of peace because he understood what it means to have peace. As a matter of fact, he is called the Prince of Peace. And he says, I leave you that peace, my peace, the same peace that I had, which enveloped my entire life as I walked this earthly journey. That's the peace I'm leaving for you, a peace that will stabilize you when things get difficult. And so we don't have to go to the bottle. We don't have to go to the spliff. We don't have to go to any of these things, because we know the peace of God is able to keep us, and that peace does not have any negative consequences. The peace of God stabilizes us. It surpasseth all understanding. The peace of God sustains us for all eternity. It is not temporary. Once we receive it, and once we allow God's presence to be in our lives constantly, once we nurture it, then that peace will last us forever. But Pastor, what is this peace you're talking about? This peace is the presence of the indwelling Holy Spirit that lives and reigns in our lives. This peace is that which is imputed by God when we accept Christ as his Lord and Savior. This peace is that gift of grace that is implanted in our lives. This peace is not some great philosophy by some great thinker. This peace is a gift that God gives us that causes us to live a life that is serene and calm even in the midst of difficult circumstances. My peace I give to you. And the tense of that whole idea of giving to you is one that says it is a definite act. It's a reality. It's a possession that we can have. So when the difficult times of life comes, we can feel that sense of stability, that sense of sustainability. We can know for sure that the peace of God, the shalom of God, is resting over us and in us. And so today, as you grieve the loss of Jamal, your loved one, or loved one, I want to say to you that death is not the end. That God has a greater plan. And today you're going to go to the cemetery, you're going to see a lot of graves where persons would have died maybe 50, 100, 200 years ago. And you've also seen that perhaps that those persons may have lived maybe just only 50 or 60 years. So this journey here in life, called life, is a very short journey compared to eternity. This peace we're talking about will last you in this life and for all eternity. And we get this peace by first acknowledging that we are sinners, Secondly, by recognizing that Christ died for us, that we can be beneficiaries of this peace. And by thirdly, living our lives according to his will and his word, so his peace can become manifested in how we live. And so today, just want to remind each one of you that even in the midst of your pain, you can experience the peace of God if we are willing to allow him to be the Lord of our Savior. Our hearts today burn for Mali, Master Yota. Our hearts burn for this young man who has gone so soon. A lot of hope, a lot of promise, a lot of plans, I'm sure. And what it says to us is that youth and age and those things, though they are wonderful, death can still come and bulldoze its way through them. I say bulldoze because death is an intruder. And what it says to me, I'm sure maybe to you as well, that we need to be able to take care of our eternity from now. Doesn't matter what age we are, whether we are 20, 25, 15, doesn't matter, 40, doesn't matter. But because life is so short and uncertain, we've got to take care of our eternal destiny. And so this morning, my challenge to each one of you is simply this. Why not today allow the peace of God to reign in your lives from now to eternity by accepting Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, by repenting of your sin and by allowing him to become your master, so that you will be able to be a beneficiary of this shalom peace. So when death comes or disaster comes or whatever comes, you can feel assured that the peace of God is in your life and that all shall be well because our God is still in control. May the peace of God rest upon each one of us today, and may he be your guide and Lord and Savior as you continue. And may the soul of our departed brother, may his soul rest in peace, and may he one day rise in glory. In our church, we pray for those family members who are going through their time of loss. But before I pray for the family members, I want to pray for the entire congregation, though, because I believe that Jamal's death has really caused us to begin to think about a lot of different things in our lives. And I want to pray for the entire church this morning, if you allow me to. Bow our heads for a few moments. The challenge today is to guard your eternity by accepting Christ as Lord and Savior. And so, gracious God, today I pray for this entire congregation, Lord. Father, I do not know those who may have made that commitment to you, but Lord, I know that you know and that they know. And so, gracious God, I pray today for your presence even now, Lord, to cause each one of us, Lord, to take a long, hard look at our eternity, Lord, and to make, oh Father, some decisions today, Lord, about ourselves and where we are and where we want to be. Pray, God, this morning that if there's anyone in here that doesn't know you as Lord and Savior, that, Father, in this very moment, Lord, that they would reach out and repent, Lord, and receive you as their Lord. That, Lord, that they would know for sure that your Spirit has brought to them that peace, Lord, in the midst of the storms of life. I pray, God, today that you will cause us, Lord, to look to you, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Almighty God, stand guard with us today in a very special and unique way. And Lord, we give you thanks. In Jesus' name, amen. If you don't know Christ as Lord and Savior, just want a prayer. A prayer, won't you just repeat it after me? And if you repeat it after me, you want to connect with us in the service, feel free to do that. That's fine. Almighty God, just repeat after me if you don't know Christ. Almighty God, this morning, I repent of my sin. I ask you, O God, to forgive me. I want to experience your peace that comes through your Spirit. Amen and amen. If you've prayed that prayer, then know for certain that God is indeed with you. And let us know at the end so we can probably talk to you a little bit more about this new path, this new way. Hallelujah. I want to invite the relatives of Jamar to just come and stand around the casket. I want to pray with you this morning. I want to pray for God's strength as you journey. Just come and just stand around the casket if you can stand. And you can hold hands as well, I guess. You're all family now, so that should be okay. Just hold hands around the casket. We want to pray with you. I want to invite the entire church to stand as a symbol of solidarity and support for those who are here standing today. Jesus. Almighty God, this morning as we stand in your sanctuary, Lord, we remember this family, Lord, in a very special way. And Lord, we are so aware of your word, Lord, that reminds us that you care for us, Lord. Lord, I think about the book of Luke and that woman, that Nain, Lord, whose only son was being carried out, Lord, and how she was mourning, Lord, and you came by, Lord, and you made a difference. Pray, God, even now this morning, Lord, that you would make a difference in the lives of those who are here standing, Lord. And Father, we know that the journey ahead is going to be long. And Lord, there'll be times of tears, Lord, when their pillows are drenched, Lord. There are times when they would, Lord, hear the voice, oh Father, of Jamal, oh God. And there are times, Lord, when they would feel, Lord, his nearness, Lord. And sometimes they would laugh and sometimes, Lord, they'll cry, Lord. But I pray, God, that amidst the every situation of their lives, Lord, that they will know that you are with them, Lord. And that, Father, Lord, you will manifest your presence. I pray, God, that you would send in their lives individuals that will comfort them, Lord, during this time. Persons that would counsel them, that would remind them that though it is hard to understand, Lord, that you still care. Does Jesus care? Oh, yes, he cares. For his heart is touched with our grief. Lord, strengthen them for the journey ahead. And we give you thanks and we give you praise. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you. You may return to your seat. Thank you. As we sing our final hymn, God and God Alone. It's okay, take your time. Thank you.
God and God alone created all these things we call our own, from the mighty to the small, the glory of them all is God's and God's alone. God and God alone reveals the truth of all we call unknown. All the best and worst of man can't change the master's plan. It's God's and God's alone. God and God alone is fit to take the universe's throne. Let everything that lives, let everything serve its truest praise. For God and God alone, last verse, God and God alone will be the joy, will be the joy of our eternal hearts will never tire of God and God alone. Oh, God and God alone. See, God and God alone is fit to take the universe's throne. Truest praise for God and God alone. God and God alone. See, God and God alone is fit to take the universe's throne. Deserve its truest praise for God and God alone. Let us stand at this time as we say our benediction. Praise the Lord. Pastor Taylor, could you do our benediction?
May the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit reign and rest upon us now and forevermore. Amen and amen.
All I I took your presence for granted, but I always cared.
Oh,
Grace and peace be unto you. This is the committal service for Jamal, Jamar, Derek, Octave, Pearce. Let's pause for a brief word of prayer. Almighty God, we give you thanks today for Jamal and for his life. And we pray, God, even now for those of us who mourn his passing. May your presence, Almighty God, be with us even now. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. It's already there, so.
For as much as it hath pleased Almighty God in his great mercy to take unto himself the soul of our dear brother, here departed, we therefore commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, in the sure and certain hope of the resurrection to life eternal through our Lord Jesus Christ, who shall change our corruptible body, that it may be like unto his glorious body, according to the working of his mighty power, whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself.
Oh, you doing? Look, come back here. Let mama see. Let mama see.
Let me sit down.
Let's take it up one more time. Every praise.
I don't mind though. I'm glad to be free. You know what I'm saying?
Joy that you promised me, tell me it's alright. The truth is,
I almost gave up, but a power that I can't explain.
That Holy Ghost power, y'all.
Fell from heaven like a shower down.
Now I know we've been hurt, y'all, but still,
I smile.
Come on.
Even though I hurt, see, I smile.
Can y'all feel that?
I know God is working, so I smile. Even though I've been here for a while,
still,
I smile.
Hallelujah. Whatever you're in right now,
smile for me.
Smile.
Can you just smile for me?
And my people say,
oh, 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 you look so much better when you're, oh, oh, oh.
Yeah,
oh, oh.
And why you praying?
You look so much better when you're, oh, oh.
Look in the mirror.
You look so much better when you're, oh, oh.
Always remember.
You look so much better when you smile.
Come on.
I almost gave up.
I almost gave up.
That I can't explain.
But the Holy Ghost power, y'all,
fell from heaven. Like
came down from heaven.
Down.
Hardships, difficulties,
right now.
Tears, storms. This is what I do. Oh, that feels good.
I know God is working, so I smile.
All things are working.
Even though I've been here for a while,
still,
I smile. Smile.
Hallelujah.
It's so hard to look up when you've been down.
I know it's hard right now.
Sure would hate to see you give up now.
Because you're a winner.
You look so much better when you smile.
You look better.
So smile.
Oh, oh, oh. Dallas.
You look so much better when you, oh, oh.
New Orleans.
You look so much better when you, oh,
come on.
Cleveland. You look so much better when you're, oh, oh, oh.
Detroit.
You look so much better when,
yeah,
you're, oh, oh, oh.
Philly.
You look so much better when you're, oh, oh, oh.
Jersey.
You look so much better when you're, oh, oh, oh.
LA.
You look so much better when you're, oh, oh.
All my people say,
you look so much better when you smile.
See, I just don't want you to be happy, cause then you gotta have something happen. I want you to have joy, cause can't nobody take that from you. I see you smiling. Y'all want some more? Y'all want some more of that? Are y'all sure y'all want some more of that?
I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails.
I love you, Lord,
all my days,
for your mercy never fails me.
From all my that I waste, I've been held in
till I lay my head.
From the moment that I wake
of the goodness
till I lay my head,
oh, I will say,
cause all my life you have been faithful.
And I just want to pray
all my life you have been so,
so
good.
And
with every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
And I'll be church, just
I love your voice.
As you go through the table of God,
you have led me through the fire.
And the peace of God
in darkest night,
which passeth all understanding,
you are close like no other.
Jesus Christ, our Lord.
I've known you as a father.
God with you.
I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God.
'Cause all my life you have been faithful.
Oh yes, you have.
'Cause all my life you have been so, so good. Every breath that I am blessed, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. So, so